Hello friends, today we will be studying about the topic microwave techniques, that is unit 3 of communication and computer network. It is for the students of electrical and electronics of diploma. So let's begin with the contents what we will be studying today. So the contents are, first, the advantages and problems of microwave, then microstrip and strip line, waveguide, cavity resonator, half wavelength waveguide as cavity resonator, circular resonant, adjustable or tunable cavity resonator. The next, applications of cavity resonator, microwave tubes, two cavity klystron amplifier, and last one, microwave antenna we will be studying. Okay, let's begin. First, why we are using this microwave techniques? Because many new communication services have been added that time, and the increased number of users had crowded the waves. To overcome this problem, electromagnetic spectrum has been extended into higher frequency. The expansion took place in VHF and UHF ranges signals. So this frequency range was greater than, the frequency range which is greater than 1 gigahertz, they are called as microwaves. So where they are used? They were used in cellular, mobile and DTH, etc. So next, what are the advantages of microwave communication? More bandwidth available, hence large amount of information can be transmitted. Then multiple channels available with more space, hence no interference. Small size antennas were required. Here small size antennas are required and no cable is needed. The next one, problems. What are the problems in microwave communication? At higher frequency, it becomes difficult to analyze electronic circuits. Semiconductors do not work properly over here. Then towers are expensive to build. And any person who is going to operate, they will be required to study about it. That is, special knowledge and skills are required for the operating. Okay, so these are the problems over here. Then next, microstrip and strip line. So this microstrip is what? Here, the flat conductor, it is separated by a dielectric, and below that dielectric, there will be a ground plane. So, how it will be? A ground plane will be there on top of that dielectric, on top of that a flat conductor. So, the length of the microstrip is quarter wavelength or half wavelength. Okay, at microwave frequency, wavelength is of the order of few centimeter. Here the ground plane is the circuit common. Then next, strip line. It is a flat conductor. Okay, so here two ground planes are there, and in between that there will be a conductor will be placed. So it is a flat conductor sandwiched between two ground planes. Okay, here the wavelength of the strip line is usually 1/4 wavelength, that is lambda by 4 or 1/2 lambda by 2 wavelength. Both this strip line and microstrip are widely used to form tuned circuit to use microwave receiver. The next one, waveguide. So this waveguide, it is nothing but a hollow metal tube. It is designed to carry microwave energy from one place to another. That is, to carry energy between pieces of equipment or over a long distance. So these waveguides, they are made up of copper, aluminium or brass, which has low resistivity. These metals are extruded into long rectangular or circular pipes. So here the waveguides completely contains the signal, so the nothing escape by the radiation. So this all, most of the waveguides, how they will be, as you can see in the diagram, they will be in a rectangular shape. Understood? Okay, the next one, so you can see here, this is the waveguide which is in the form of rectangular shape. The next one, cavity resonator. So this cavity resonators, it is important microwave device. Cavity resonator is a waveguide derived component which provides proper coupling. So for coupling of the your devices and impedance matching, it is used. Okay, so types of cavity resonator, it is half wavelength, half wavelength waveguide as cavity resonator, then circular waveguide as cavity resonator, adjustable or tunable cavity resonator is there. Then in that adjustable or tunable cavity resonator, there are two types: cylindrical cavity with adjustable disc and cavity with adjustable plugs. The next, half wavelength waveguides as cavity resonators. So here it is the simple cavity resonators can be formed with a small piece of waveguide, half wavelength long. So here what it will be, there will be a small probe. Through that probe, the microwave energy is injected. The result is that the signal will bounce off at the short ends of the waveguide and reflect back towards the probe. Okay, so like this, this half wavelength as cavity resonator will be working. Then next, circular resonator. So here, a cavity, here it can be also formed by using a short section of circular waveguide. So you can see in the diagram, there will be two probes will be there. The diameter, it will be lambda by 2 at operating frequency. So here, the coupling loop is commonly used in cavity resonator. So here in this resonator, two probes are there. As I told you, one it will be input and one will be output. So here the cavity can also act as a filter over here. Then next one is what? Your adjustable or tunable cavity resonator. So in this adjustable or tunable cavity resonator, there are two types: cylindrical cavity and adjustable disc. And one more is cavity with adjustable plug. Both the diagrams you can see over here. So first diagram in this what? A cylindrical cavity with adjustable disc. Okay. So here what it will be? An adjustable, you can see over there, screw is there. Okay. So that screw moves the end wall in and out. So whenever you tighten, it will go inside. Whenever you loose out, it will come outside. The smaller the cavity, the higher is the operating frequency over here. The next diagram you can see over there, cavity with adjustable plug. So here you can see that the tuning can be done and adjusted by using the plugs on the sides of the cavity which are there. As the plug is screwed in, more of it is protrudes into the cavity and operating frequency increases. So it means this cavity is there, that adjustable plugs, as you tighten them, the frequency will be increased more. Okay, in this. Then what are the applications of this cavity resonators? Cavity resonators are tunable circuits. Tunable means what? We can increase or decrease. Okay. Then next, microwave oscillator generates microwave signals in reflex crystal and magnetron. Here, microwave amplifiers, we can use them, they are used then in wave meters, then in filter circuits they are used. Then next, we will be studying about microwave tubes. So these microwave tubes, like transistors, these are the devices used for controlling a large signal with a smaller signal. So to produce what? Amplification, oscillation, switching and other operation. So these microwave tubes, what are their types and each type where they are applicable, means applications of them we will be discussing. First one is klystron. So klystron is used for power amplification at microwave frequency. Then second one is reflex klystron. This reflex klystron, they are used for low power microwave oscillators. Okay. The next is magnetron. This is used for high power microwave oscillators. They are used for heating purpose in microwave ovens and radar systems. The next one is traveling wave tube. So these are nothing but RF power amplifier. They are used in satellite transponders. Okay. The next we will be studying about two cavity klystron amplifier. So here the two cavity klystron amplifier, as you can see in the diagram, it consists of evacuated glass tube. So there is a glass tube that you can see. Then within it, what is there? You can see at the bottom, there is a cathode. The next focusing electrodes are there. The next two cylindrical cavity resonators are there, called buncher. Then next, what it is there? Or output cavity with a small gap. And at last, what you can see, there it is a collector, okay? Or it is called as a plate. So how it works, that we will be seeing over here. So this two cavity klystron amplifier, it is a microwave vacuum tube using cavity resonator. So these electrons, how they are emitted? By using the cathode. So electrons are emitted by cathode and are focused into narrow beam. They are focused into narrow beam by electrostatic and electromagnetic focusing. So you can see their focusing electrode is there. So using that, it is focused. Okay. Then thus the current flow is established between the cathode and anode. So anode is nothing but at top you can see that is the collector. Okay. So next, the microwave signal to be amplified is applied to the input cavity. Then this sets up electric and magnetic field in cavity which influence the electron beam. It will cause the electrons to speed up during positive half cycle, and during the negative half cycle, what will happen? It will slow down. Okay. A process of altering the velocity of electrons according to microwave signal applied is called velocity modulation. So means according to the input, the variation, it is called as the modulation. Okay. Due to velocity modulation, bunches of electrons are produced by input cavity. Then the space between input cavity and output cavity is called what? Drift space. You can see in the diagram it is masked. The space between what? Upper and lower, in between what it is, there is a drift space. Okay. Bunches of electrons move in drift space, in clouds. Today the collectors and pass through the output cavity. Then bunches of electron passing the catcher gap results in current density modulation. A small microwave signal applied at the buncher cavity results into a large power. Klystrons are used at frequency as low as UHF and as high as 100 GHz in microwave range. So this drift space, they will be amplifying the signal, and at last the catcher cavity will be there. Then these, at last you will be sending to the collector. The collector, what it will do? It will collect all the electrons. The collector will be what? It will be positive. So the cathode will be negative. So electrons, they will be negative. So they will be attracted to the positive. So in that manner, they will go amplified and get to the plate, to the collector. In this manner, this two cavity klystron amplifier will be working. Okay. The next one, what we will be studying about the horn antenna. Horn antenna. In this, here, the most widely used microwave antenna, it is nothing but your horn antenna. It is the extension of waveguide. Actually, a waveguide will act as an inefficient radiator in free space if it is simply left open at the end. Hence, waveguide end is flared, which creates a horn and achieve impedance matching and lowers the loss, as greater gain, directivity and large bandwidth. So, horn antenna is opened out waveguide, which couples electric field fully into this space. So you can see there is an opening, mouth or aperture of horn it is, you can see. So like that opening, it is nothing but called as the horn. Means you can see any horn, how it will be at the opening. So like that it has been spread, so it is called as the horn antenna. So there will be a rectangular waveguide. Through that waveguide, the microwave signals will be traveling, and it will be sent to the direction of the radiation. So like that horn antenna will be there. You can see in the diagram. The next one is parabolic antenna. So this parabolic reflector is a large dish shaped structure made up of metal or screen mesh. Okay. So you can see, no, it is that this is an example of what you can see, the DTH antennas. Your DTH antennas, there we are using, all those antennas are nothing but parabolic antennas. Okay. So here the horn antenna is placed at the focal point. Means the horn antenna, you can see in the detail, it will be at the center, and the parabolic antenna, you can see it will be front of it. Okay, so that DTH antenna, those are receiver, not transmitters. During transmission, the horn radiates the signal. Now we are studying that is at transmission. So during the transmission, what will happen? The horn will radiate the signal towards the parabolic reflector. You can see in the diagram. Okay, so when it will send it to the parabolic reflector, what will happen? It will get bounce the reflector, which bounces the wave and radiates them, and it will radiate them into the narrow parallel beam. Okay, you can see as seen in the diagram, you can see that. Then during receiving part, the parabolic reflector, what they will do, they will pick up the signals from the space, okay, and the electronic signals, and bounces the waves towards what, the antenna at the focal point. The result is extremely high gain narrow beam with antenna. Okay, so by this we will be completing this unit 3. Thank you.